let's go back into the action in the East with an early season surprise, the Indiana Pacers. Last spring, Indiana found themselves in a hard-fought battle with the top-seeded Chicago Bulls in the opening round of the playoffs.
Time running out on the Indiana Pacers. The Bulls take the series in five.
In terms of, you know, us losing 4-1, we're not satisfied with that. As far as how hard we have to play and what we have to do in order to be a team like Chicago, it makes us come out here every night to perform at a high level.
They're really building on this young crew. That they've got a good nucleus of youth and energy here.
The postseason experience seems to have been an important step for the young and talented core, now coming of age under head coach Frank Vogel.
Coach Vogel's a great guy. He's a great coach. He understands the game, and he's a young guy. I mean, he has that enthusiasm in him.
Your passing is spectacular. But keep it up. Extra pass, extra pass, extra pass.
He can get, you know, anybody pumped.
We are a better rebounding team than this team is. We're a better rebounding team. Look at your size. You two guys come back, you compete. No one's bigger than you, you compete.
He just makes you believe, and any coach that can make you believe that you can do anything out there, that's great for a team and their confidence.
That confidence was clearly evident as the Pacers started strong, aided in large part by the free agent signing of David West.
He was a big-time scorer in New Orleans, and he's showing to be a big-time scorer in Indiana.
Everybody enjoys each other's company. You know, it's fun out there on the floor. We have fun at practice.
Oh, yeah, B-Rex! Block!
But at the same time, everybody knows what the main goal is, so it feels good when everybody's on the same page.
Granger against Prince goes inside. Nice pass to Hibbert. Dunks it home on a foul.
The Pacers' front court also features the up-and-coming Roy Hibbert and all-star forward Danny Granger.
I'm continuing to learn from Danny. He has a lot of game to teach. He's a great shooter.
Ball goes way outside to Granger.
Wow. Great score in low post. He defends well. I mean, Danny's been like a big brother and a mentor for me.
Your game is nasty. Your game is nasty.
In his second season, Paul George has taken great strides and is currently averaging over 11 points and nearly 5 rebounds a game.
At 6'9", the athletic ability that he has.
Dante Jones rims out, slammed down on the follow by Paul George. He is a high flyer.
It's basketball IQ.
George blocks the shot.
The way he's able to shoot the ball now, and the sky's the limit for him. You know, I see him being a very special player in the future.
Tyler Hansbro is feeling fine after missing 65 games in his first two seasons, justifying the faith placed in the 13th pick in the 09 draft.
Oh, Tyler Hansbro!
My rookie year was a real rough start, going through the injuries and sitting back and watching the team play for the whole year and sitting out listening to people doubt me. Kind of build up a fire, and you know, I was really glad to get back on the court.
And his tenacity on the floor has been the key to his production.
Takes it away from Boozer. And a foul.
Wow. Just the fact that he plays hard all the time, the ball finds him.
That's what he does. Tyler Hansbro, he knows where the ball is. He has that nose for the ball.
You can't measure heart and you can't measure desire. He has both of those things.
Misses, got his own rebound to jam.
You know, a lot of guys don't want to mix it up with him, don't have the energy to mix it up with him. And as long as he does that, he's going to have a place in this league.